300 acres, 10 miles south of town. A drifter who decided it was time to settle down. There was no sea he had not sailed, or sky he had not flown. And the only place he'd never been was a place he could call his own. He broke the soil and planted seed, but the land refused to yield. And the loneliness he felt at night was the kind no man should feel. Till a woman came into his life, a daughter of the soil, a bride that he could stand beside and ease his daily toil. And he called his kingdom Jason's Farm. The land grew rich and green for King Jason and his queen. And the wind blew sweet each night time as they lay in each other's arms. And all things good grew on Jason's farm. When the summer sun had finally gone and harvest time was near, Jason's pretty Mary whispered magic in his ear. And Jason's laughter filled the land, and his soul began to sing. And he boasted of the son his wife would bear him in the spring. And all things good grew on Jason's farm. The land beneath the skies turned as green as Mary's eyes. And he felt the child grow strong in Mary's womb against his palm. And all things good grew on Jason's farm. Now the Lord gives and he takes away. To all men this is true, and most of us accept it and learn to live it through. Now God gave a child to Jason, an extension of his life, but in doing so he traded the child for Jason's wife. The crops are rotting in the fields, the land left unattended. Somewhere Jason roams the earth, his wounded heart unmending. The house is slowly falling in the dust of Jason's yard, a monument to a man who shunned his child and cursed his God. And nothing grows no more on Jason's farm. The land once rich and green is dead and dry like Jason's dream. And the wind that once blew sweet through Mary's hair is strangely calm. And nothing grows no more on Jason.